Christine Lilly and Karina LeBlanc inside the Boston locker room, and Marinette Pichon leading the charge. Philadelphia hosting the Breakers at Villanova Stadium. The Breakers coming into the game in first place of the WUSA, a point up on Atlanta. Philadelphia trying to work its way out of the basement and back into the playoff picture. Hi, I'm Beth Mowens, along with Anson Dorrance. And Anson, unfortunately for Philly, that job getting a lot tougher. Starting defender Jenny Benson out today with a red card suspension. And Heather Mitz, the fourth starter this year for Philly, knocked out of the lineup due to an injury.
Well, Heather Mitz is playing the best soccer of her life. The national team was looking at her for the World Cup. Here's the injury, kneecap to kneecap. Callie Withers, Atlanta, knocked out, sitting on the sideline. She gets back in. That's the kind of gut she plays with. And here is the Philly shape, a 4-5-1. Pichon trying to get in over the top, either side and through. Hoffman trying to play underneath. Flank midfielders, Misaki and Burke trying to get in on the outside. That's their shape. This is their attack.
On the other side for Boston, in third place in large part to the play of Maren Miner.
Well, Miner does so well underneath the defense. Here she is striking a ball from about 20. Here it is, 22, bent in to beat Siri Mullenix. Dagny Melgren likes the ball over the top and through. Typical direct Norwegian style. Very good at running onto these. Very good at finishing them. Lethal running through direct soccer. Classic speed to beat defenses over the top.
Lori Fair will be wearing the microphone for us today. She and her charge teammates looking to help out Marinette Pichon.
Let's make sure on, like, when Pichon starts to go.
Right.
Let's all just, because sometimes I think she'll just decide to go without somebody telling her.
Okay.
We got to go with it.
Okay.
You go first.
No, you go.
There's a better way to get rid of blackheads.
Ouch.
New Clean and Clear Blackhead Clearing Scrub has multi-action beads that clean deep and keep blackheads away. Clean and clear and under control.
It's the bottom of the ninth, 4-3, two on, two out for the entire season in the balance. There's no reason to hold anything back now. It all comes down to this.
Just hang in there.
Games don't come any bigger, and this one is going right down to the wire. The pitch,
go.
He got a hold of it. It's
yes.
Gone!
The Hyundai Sonata with America's best warranty. 10 years, 100,000 miles. When you don't miss a thing, you win.
Ooh, scary.
Yeah, and I bet they didn't have that insurance back then.
What?
Aflac.
It gives your mommy money if she's sick and can't work.
What does?
Aflac.
Pay attention.
To what?
Aflac.
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Aflac.
Honey, wipe your face.
Stains just aren't a big problem with the Maytag Neptune. Features like Stain Brain take the guesswork out of stain removal. And the Turbo Clean Wash System powers out tough stains. Right now, save up to $150 on Maytag washers. There's never been a better time to buy the longest lasting brand of washers available. Visit Maytag.com to find a dealer near you.
Maytag, depend on us.
Ready for this? I call it the Super Slammer.
Dunk your grandma.
Skip to my loo.
Do the legs. Behind the back. Chocolate thunder attack.
Gorilla. Head turning.
Spine chilling.
What you feeling? Ah! Horizontal monumental turbo power magical rim rack. Yeah.
Got a nasty cut? Get state-of-the-art protection. Band-Aid brand advanced healing.
This amazing gel strip stays put for days.
And it's clinically proven to help cuts heal faster.
Advanced healing. Only from Band-Aid brand.
Today's game is brought to you by Hyundai. Hyundai reminds you when you get everything you want at standard, you win. By the U.S. Soccer Foundation. Proud to support the WUSA. By Aflac. Ask about it at work. And by Maytag. Depend on us. Let's take a look at the starting lineup brought to you by Clean and Clear. Angela Euclides had a game-winning goal against New York on Wednesday night, her first goal of the season.
So
Hello. Today I'll be playing center midfield for the Boston Breakers, and I have a few responsibilities in that position. First one is to possess the ball, clean up things in the midfield, as well as switch the point of attack and win some head balls. But I think my most important job of the day would be to order Christine Lilly around, make sure she has a good head on her shoulders and gets her job done.
Clean and clear starting lineup for the Philadelphia Charge includes rookie Rachel Cruz making her third consecutive start.
Today I'll be playing defensive center mid, and at that position, I will try to prevent Boston from having any scoring opportunities. On offense, I will try to keep the ball and play simple.
LeBlanc in goal for Boston on the left, the Canadian international. And Melissa Moore in goal for the Charge, trying to bounce back from a tough outing against Atlanta. The Charge defense had been solidifying over the last couple of weeks, but Atlanta exploding for four goals in their win last weekend against Philadelphia. The Charge in their home reds and the Boston Breakers in their visiting white tops with the black shorts.
Shapes are a bit different, as I mentioned earlier. Philly plays with one high, five in midfield, and four in the back. And the Breakers more classically in 4-4-2.
Let's take a look at your super stat today, Anson.
We're going to see. Both these teams have direct players. Melgren plays directly, so does Pichon. We're going to see how often they try to get these kids in directly and how often they're called offsides, because Pichon obviously plays right on that line, has an issue with that, so let's take a look.
She has been leading the league most of the season in offside calls. The throw-in now, Melgren putting it quickly back into play. Donnie Melgren and Maren Minor combining for 14 of Boston's 19 goals on the season. The second best scoring combo in the league behind Danielle Fotopoulos and Birgit Prinz of Carolina. A terrific afternoon here at Villanova Stadium in suburban Philadelphia, 84 degrees. The humidity not as high as it has been in recent days in this area. It's a synthetic field turf, which under the hot sun can get very hot for the players. Kate Sobrero trying to blast that one over the touch, and does so. The national team defender for the United States. And there is Marinette Pichon. Marinette coming in with eight goals, tying her for the league lead with Maren Minor. Kurt looking for Pichon. And taken away. Tijan Prazo steps in, taking over at midfield. We talked a little bit about the Philadelphia lineup, Anson. They have had to make a lot of adjustments. Jenny Benson out today due to a red card suspension that she picked up against Atlanta last week. And then the four injured players, most recently Heather Mitz. So they have had to really change things up this year. As we take a look at the Band-Aid injury report, Tracy Dukar, the backup goalkeeper, still has some knee issues that she's been battling throughout the season.
And, you know, with all that stuff in mind about the injuries and the different lineups, Pia Sundhage, the Boston Breakers coach, is going to run at these defenders 1v1. That's a part of her game plan. Also try to get his two central midfielders forward. So she's going to see if she can exploit this.
Charge hope to have Kelly Smith back in a month. The others are not so sure about. Arrington out with an ACL injury. Mitz hopes to be back in 4 to 6 weeks. Now here come the Breakers. Munire Begay, the French international. Good ball to Melgren. Dogny into the area. Plays it back to Jenna Klugel, the second-year pro out of the University of North Carolina. Dispossessed by Stacy Tulloch. Now Munire Begay getting by one defender. Melgren, touched back from Kupis. Philly trying to clear it out. This is Aaron Misaki, the rookie out of Portland, trying to play it over the top to Pichon. Marinette looking to run on. Almost put the hat on Sobrero. Kate would have none of that.
That's what I loved. As soon as they got the ball in the midfield, I saw Pichon's finger go out. She was pointing for the ball through and over the top. So not only is she one of the best in the world at this, she wants it all the time.
Here's Lori Farah with a little Aflac turf talk.
Hey guys, everything's safe, you know what I mean? Make friends for each other.
Five of us work together, work hard. We gotta be hard. Let's do this. Here we go. DFC. 1, 2, 3, D!
That was Lori in the pregame huddle. Just a young player, but Anson really has taken over part of the leadership role for this Philadelphia Charge team as a member of the U.S. national team. Has terrific international experience.
Yes, she does, and obviously with all the adjustments that Philly is making, she's got the versatility to drop into the back. She actually played there for me collegiately at the University of North Carolina, so I know she's comfortable back there. But these two front runners are playing against, it's probably the best tandem in the league, and so this will be a challenge for them.
And trying to do so without defender Heather Mitz, who now joins us in the booth. First of all, we wish you we could watch you down there on the field, but the second best thing, I guess, is to have you up here. First of all, tell us a little bit, how do you feel with the knee injury?
It feels great. You know, obviously, I went back in the game and kept playing, so the fact that I can't play today, I don't really understand why. It's tough.
By the way, you won everyone's respect with that, because here you are with a broken leg and you insist to be put back in. I think that gives you a wonderful credibility.
Well, thanks.
Hits the side of the crossbar as Christine Lilly was making a push forward. What have you guys been talking about in the last day or so, getting the game plan ready for Boston when you're trying to face players like Lilly and Minert and Nolgren?
Well, I think the most important thing is that we've decided to man mark Minert. So I think that's a huge adjustment for us. Mary McVay is able to step back in. She's familiar with that position. She played there before I stepped in, so obviously she has some experience, which is nice. And like Anson was saying, Lori's familiar with the right side as well, the outside back position. And Stacey Tolik actually played left back a little bit in college for Arizona, so I think that helps a lot for our defense, you know?
The other thing, Beth, we saw this last week, the Boston Breakers have to deal with 5 against 4 in midfield. And we remember how much New York struggled with that against San Diego. So let's see what happens here with Boston.
New York eventually made the adjustment. Tom Cermani, the coach for the Power, changing things up. And we saw how much that affected the game. Gonzalez trying to play it up front. And a goal kick coming up for Philadelphia. Well, the injury, unfortunately, Heather, comes at a difficult time. It seemed like, as a team, you guys were really had turned a corner after a slow start and were getting things back together.
Yeah, it's bad timing just because we are, even though we are in last place, I mean, everybody in the league right now is so close in points. So we were hoping that we could just kind of carry on each every game and try to work towards getting a couple more wins here. But hopefully that won't change.
Yep, with the...
The other thing, Heather, you're playing so well. The national team was looking at you. I know that's a dream of yours. And, boy, you were basically right there playing the best soccer of your life. And they're looking at bringing in young defenders. And so talk about that. Can you get back in time?
Yeah, I think so. I wrote April an email and asked her just to please not count me out yet. And I got a very positive email back. Obviously, I don't know what's going to happen with the injury, but hopefully I've been rehabbing. It feels really good. So hopefully I'll be back in 4 weeks or less.
Haven't you sent April a copy of the tape to show that it doesn't matter if your leg is broken? It's
I can
willing
play
to
right now.
To play, sure.
Here comes an opportunity for Boston. Christine Lilly lets it go and misses just wide. Right as Lilly was looking for her first goal of the season.
Well, here are the issues when you're dealing with Boston. Yes, we talk about the M&M twins up top, but let's not forget about Christine Lilly. Here she is getting in on the left side. Great touch to go right to goal. She had an option in the middle, but she also had that option lower right. Just missed lower right. Great run by Christine Lilly.
Lilly with 3 assists on the season. And not only had her an opportunity to play on the U.S. national team, but in recent years you've also had a chance to play with players like Christine Lilly as a teammate. What does that experience with the U.S. side do for your game, and how does that help you improve?
Well, obviously, even if it's a couple of days going into camp, being able to play against those players is such a great experience, and I think that it makes you a better player, being able to play against the best.
Well, Heather, we're going going to set you free. Thank you for joining
us. Thank you for having
me. I want you to go down there and support the team.
I will.
We saw you there in the huddle. And obviously come back. Your team needs you. United States needs you. So good health.
Take care.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Heather Mitz, starting central defender this year for the Philadelphia Charge, and hopefully she'll have an opportunity to get back into the lineup for Philadelphia and perhaps for the United States as well, with the U.S. hosting the World Cup in September and October. Wouldn't that be something if Heather had the opportunity to play here in Philadelphia, Lincoln Financial Field, one of the sites for the World Cup and one of the places that the United States will be playing. There's Pia Swintog coming back home in her first year as head coach with Boston after a couple of seasons as an assistant coach here with the Philadelphia Charge last year. And she helped orchestrate, along with Coach Mark Krikorian, the best defense in the league. And has certainly shown big improvements for Boston in that area this season.
Unquestionably, if you even look at the stats to date, they've only had three games where they've allowed more than one goal. That's remarkable. So she's reconstructed it brilliantly.
In fact, in the last four games, Boston has allowed one goal or fewer. After struggling early, we saw them in that 6-0 loss to Atlanta early in the season. They quickly rallied from that. Now in first place in the league. One of four teams that has spent some time in first place through the first half of the season. Some tremendous parity this year in the WUSA. And as Heather Mitz alluded to, the standing's still pretty tight for Mark Krikorian in his third season. Last year's coach of the year in the league. He knows this squad is really only three wins away from getting right back into it. Just 9 points separating first from last place.
It's about as close as it possibly can be. And I know it's going to be hard for him, having lost the quality and the number of players that he's lost, but still, even watching them play today, they're playing with a possessional mentality. They're playing with good organization, and I think they are still in it.
And the good news for Mark and Philly, 6 of their last 10 games will be played here at home, so at least a little better comfort level. We are in the 12th minute. The Boston Breakers in the white jerseys, they have been very good early in matches this year. 7 goals in the first 15 minutes of play. That's the most in the league.
And it's their personalities. They just attack the goal relentlessly. As we showed in the opening, they've got varying styles up front with Melvin trying to get in directly. Minard, a wizard at finding space underneath the defense. And as we saw earlier, Christine Lilly penetrating the flanks. They have all of these weapons, and they're all superb. They're all international caliber.
We've seen all year long how important it is to get that early goal, the first score. In most instances this year has held up, and that team has gone on to win. Emily Burt in midfield. Anne McAnany plays it out to the left wing, Tullett. And Kate Sabrero steps in there. Looking for Hugh Greece. U.S. national team midfielder. A good ball through to Christine Lilly running down the left. Her cross. Knocked down there by Tijan Frazzo, and Masaki blasts it clear.
There was a seam in there for Lilly. She was trying to drive it into Maren Meinert, who was running near post. Great attack.
Sliding tackle made by Tullin. Throw in for the Breakers. Munere Begay will take it.
Here you go, left shot on the left. Don't let her get a corner. No, she's standing in the corner.
Belgium back to Munere Begay. Now Jenna Kugel. Trying to lock it in for Miner. Headed out. Boston able to maintain possession. Miner trying to play it back to Lilly, and a throw-in coming up for the Breakers.
Christine Lilly, one of the veterans in the league, still knocking and moving like a young deer out there. Always mobile, tremendous energy. It's an absolute pleasure watching her continue to mature as a player.
All all-time number one in career assists in league history. Hughley fires and just misses wide right.
That was closer than you think. She smacked it.
Let's take a look now at our Aflac trivia question of the game. How many Boston Breakers were on the 1999 World Cup rosters, plural? So perhaps there are some Americans, perhaps some Europeans,
perhaps
thrown in there as well. How many Boston Breakers made World Cup rosters in 1999? Played in the United States, of course, the Americans winning the cup, beating the Chinese. China will be back. Both Koreas, North and South Korea, have qualified. In fact, there is one spot remaining. Japan and Mexico will be playing a home-and-home aggregate series on July 5th and July 12th. The winner of that matchup will get the final spot. 16 teams playing in the World Cup. Monica Gonzalez will be leaving on Monday to join the Mexican national team. They will host the first match in Mexico City on July 5th. And the other team affected will be Atlanta. They will lose both Maribel Dominguez for Mexico and Homare Sawa for Japan for both of those matches. Throwing into the area. Keyshawn has it taken away. Munaray Begay. Lori Fair back there to clean it up. Sabrero will go ahead and play it all the way back to Karina LeBlanc. The 23-year-old goalkeeper out of British Columbia.
We can hear Coach Mark Krikorian from the booth screaming, Rachel, find her, telling Rachel Cruz to make sure she doesn't lose Myron Meinert. And there's an example of her finding her over on the sideline. Huge responsibility for this young player to play such a wily veteran. But trust me, no one likes to be shadowed.
Lily plays it in. Moore has it. Well, Cruz, the rookie, a fourth-round pick out of West Virginia, hails from Webster, New York. We saw Washington, Anson, use that effectively last season when they were making their terrific second half of the season run with Kerry Moore doing a lot of man marking.
And one of the reasons they felt they continued to improve during that stretch was because of that move with Moore marking. And so we'll see how Mark Krikorian looks at this. Obviously, Myron Meinert is someone you should try to take out of the game in some fashion. And so what he's done is he's sacrificed a player, and he's playing a 4-4-1 in effect, because her only responsibility is to stay with Myron Meinert. Even now, while her team's on the attack, you can see her shadowing Meinert.
And if I remember correctly, it worked best against the smaller finesse players like Keyshawn when Kerry Moore had trouble with the bigger, powerful players. Lori Fair for Philly. Looking for Hoffman. Today's game is brought to you by New Passion Pink Venus from Gillette. Reveal the goddess in you. By American Legacy Foundation, building a world where young people reject tobacco and anyone can quit. By McDonald's, proud to sponsor the WUSA. And by Clean and Clear, for clean, noticeably clear, beautiful skin, clean and clear and under control. 19th minute at Villanova Stadium, Philadelphia and Boston scoreless. Boston coming in first place in the league, 6-4-2 record. Philadelphia at 3-6-2. Breakers trying to make it to the playoffs. Boston and San Diego, the only two teams that have not been in the postseason as of yet in their WUSA careers. San Diego trying to put themselves into position. Four teams will advance to the playoffs.
Very patient build up here by the Philadelphia Charge. Very attractive, holding it midfield, pinging it, moving it side to side. Nice change of point there by Maury Fair. One thing that's been impressive about looking at the Boston Breakers shape, the back four are very well organized. The thing I've been most impressed with is watching Angela Hughley's drop back under the four to make sure that Hoffman is tracked, because a part of Mark Krikorian's strategy is that everyone knows Pichon's going to get in over the top, so he was thinking, let's get Hoffman underneath. And she hasn't been open because they've dropped their central midfielders on top of her very effectively.
Lily looking for Miner. Tijan Frazo is there. And we are now joined by Pia Soontag, the head coach for the Boston Breakers. And Pia, we've been talking quite a bit here early on about the man marking that Philadelphia is doing. What kinds of things can you do to try and shake Marin loose from that a little bit?
The key is her position. So she has to be a little bit higher, not checking back that often. And meanwhile, we have midfield players like Angela Hughley, for instance, take a little bit more initiative and switch a point of attack.
One thing I've enjoyed, Tia, is watching you develop this defense so well. And the thing I like is the shape is good in the back four, but also the shape in midfield is very good. The five they have are doing nothing against your four. Talk about that.
Yeah, you know what? As long as we're close to each other, and it's about the gap between the back four and the midfield, and they've been doing a good job so far. But on the other hand, we need the center mid to get a little bit closer to the two up front in attack. So it's not just good enough to have a good position in defending. The transition is very important as well.
All right, well, Pia, thank you very much. We appreciate you taking a few moments to join us.
Thank you.
21st minute, Boston and Philadelphia. A scoreless tie. Pia Soontag, the head coach of the Boston Breakers. Boston is in white, Philadelphia in the red jerseys. Philadelphia trying to keep things together despite losing two of their starting defenders to Heather Mitz to injury and Jenny Benson sitting out a red card suspension. And looking to bounce back from a tough loss against Atlanta. And speaking of the Atlanta beat, the Metrex player of the week is Atlanta's Cindy Parlow. And for Cindy, a big afternoon, not one goal, not even two, but three goals. The hat trick for Cindy Parlow in a 21-minute span as Atlanta beat the Charge. Cindy Parlow, the Metrex player of the week. The second fastest hat trick in league history. Marinette Pichon has the quickest last summer against New York. She scored three goals in 13 minutes.
Well, Cindy Parlow has also come off a great national team performance this year, Beth, where she scored four. And the area where she rules, as you can see on that series of replays, is the air. No one can track her. Not only is she tall, she has an extraordinary vertical jump.
She's been tremendous on the air. We've seen better airplay, I would say, over the course of the first season. We saw Julie Fleeting last week. A couple of headers for goals for Julie.
Julie Fleeting's quality is a bit different. It's not the height and the vertical jump that has her so devastating in the air. Her timing is impeccable. That's why she gets to every ball.
Lori Fair. Hoffman, the German international. She's got three goals on the season. Her first career goal was scored against Boston. Pichon trying to get there. LeBlanc beats her to it. Boston beat Philly 3-1 back on April 26th. Marin Miner had two goals in that game, and perhaps that's one of the big reasons, Anson, why they decided to try the man marking this time around.
Well, I'm seeing evidence of it. Not only are they marking her, but whenever anyone else is near Marin Miner, I saw Emily Burt there doubling back. So they're certainly very conscious of the kind of season she's having. Because all of us feel like she's a candidate right now to be the MVP in the league.
24th minute at Villanova Stadium. Just outside of Philadelphia, Beth Mullins along with Anson Dorrance. The WUSA on PAX. Philly and Boston scoreless next week. We're out on Long Island, the New York Power, hosting the San Jose Cyber Rays. Randy Chastain will be there, so will Tiffany Milbrick. Should be a good one. Those two teams in the middle of the pack right now. In fact, tied for fourth place heading into weekend action. New York will be hosting Carolina tonight. Bichon looking to tally, and she does! Marinette Bichon scores! Her ninth goal of the season! That's the most in the WUSA!
This is possession at its best. They're pinging it around like pros on the right side. It seems like for half an hour, back and forth, just possessing it, confidently pinging in and out, just like a 5v2 on a sideline. A nice series of moves here by Hoffman. Pulls it back. Look at this. Bichon's ready to dive in. She does. Redirects it in. They were lulled asleep by the possession on the flank. This whole attack is absolutely exquisite. Wonderful goal.
Tremendous service from the rookie Erin Misaki to get it in to Marinette Bichon. Her ninth goal of the season. And now Boston looking to counter. Well, let's see if the Breakers can do it two games in a row. They fell behind New York on Wednesday and had their first come-from-behind win of the season. Here's another look at the goal.
Well, Bichon's just waiting for this ball served in. She gets half a step. That's all she needs, and she buries it in the back of the net. But the best part of that series was the build-up, the patience on the right flank between Hoffman, Misaki, and Fair. That's an exquisite goal.
She's got over 20 goals during her career. She was the quickest player in league history to get to that number. Now for Bichon, 7 points in her last 2.5 matches. Midfield, Hoffman comes down with it, looking for Bichon. Another opportunity, Marinette. The stop. Wow, but that just shows how dangerous Marinette can be.
She is all over this, and what I loved about this actually was the pass from Melanie Hoffman. Bends it through a seam, absolutely exquisite onto Pichon's foot. That's a great attack. It looks like Bichon actually tried to nutmeg the goalkeeper. Another extraordinary opportunity. Again, loved in this is that final pass by Hoffman through, just a tremendous.
Well, the service to Bichon has been good thus far. Misaki assisting on the goal, and Hoffman almost picking one up there. Tijan Prazo blasts it up to Burt. Sobrero tried to head it out of trouble. Marinette back to get it. Philly switching fields effectively. Misaki turning it back inside. Taken away. Chrissy McCann plays it forward. Now Lily knocked off the ball. The whistle goes against Rachel Hoffman. 1-0, the charge in front. Marinette Bichon scoring in the 25th minute. Ninth of the season.
And what I loved about this whole series is look at this ball from Hoffman. She sees these two defenders, and look at here, splitting right through the defense. Not much of a seam there. And what a ball she gets through. There's no one better running onto this. She tries to nutmeg LeBlanc, but still what a great serve by Hoffman.
Now Gonzalez, Melgren back to Fuqueles. She lets it rip, saved by Moore, moving to her right. Well, Pia Sundhage telling us, one of the things with the man marking is that there could be more opportunities for Angela Fuqueles. She's ripped a couple of good shots on frame. And here she is again, coming in, playing it through to Dante Melgren with the outside of her right boot. Puts it into the back of the net. Dodney Melgren tying it up for Boston. Terrific feed from you, please.
We're seeing a clinic from these young women that like to play right on the edge of the line. Great run here by Hughley's. Perfectly timed pass as Dogny Melgren runs onto it. Drives it lower right. Look at this great series. Nice touch there by Hughley's. Perfect timing by Melgren to roll it into the lower right-hand corner. It's a clinic on playing on the edge of the restraining line by Pichon and by Melgren.
The 25-year-old Norwegian with her seventh goal of the season. And that will temporarily at least push Melgren and Minot to the top. They are the highest scoring combo in the league.
Well, the thing that's separating what we're seeing right now, this is truly a different level. Only at this level do they have the precision and timing to get each other in the way we're seeing today.
Jenna Krugel. Looking to head the other way. Pichon tried to run in front of Kate Sobrero. Sobrero able to fend her off.
The thing I love about Pichon, she did want it in over the top. I saw her on her horse basically indicating, please knock it in over the top. When it wasn't knocked in over the top, she still had the energy and discipline to come back and hassle Sobrero. Looking at this again, this is exquisite. We're seeing this great series on the top of the box here. And look at the timing of this run. Basically, the line is drawn here, and you're going to see the perfect timing as she gets in right underneath and just slots it. Looks easy when we're sitting up here, but the timing was everything. Final pass was everything. Another extraordinary goal.
Yeah, it looked like it was Tijan Frazo that tried to step forward to draw Melgren offside. Dogny towed that line. Mackinac. Come the breakers. Lily, she's been able to find space up the left side. Melgren. Play on. There's Carrie Seitz, the referee today. Emily Burt. Whistle back at where the ball was first kicked. We'll bring it all the way down to the other end. Zotac taking the opportunity with the ball out of play to coach Mary Frances Monroe.
Beth, everyone responds to Pia Sundhage. All of the players that I know that she's trained, they have huge respect for. Whatever she said right then, I'm sure, was to help construct Mary Frances Monroe's confidence or give her an idea of other things to do. And all the players really respond to her.
Sobrero again battling with Pichon. The WUSA is proud to support the American Legacy Foundation as part of Legacy Circle of Friends program. The WUSA stands with women who are trying to quit smoking and will make a donation to Legacy for every goal scored during the season. We've had a couple of them here in the first half. Marinette Pichon in the 25th minute, and then Dogny Melgren in the 29th to tie it up. Hoffman again looking for Pichon over the top.
This is the best I've ever seen Melanie Hoffman play. She's all over the field. She's winning balls. Her final serve has been superb, that one included. And she's another one of those great finds for Coach Mark Krikorian, who seems to have this incredible ability to find amazing foreign talent and assemble it. If he'd been more lucky and had more of his lineup out there because of all the injuries, we'd see another extraordinary Philadelphia Charge team. But I like what Hoffman's done so far in today's game, in every respect.
Jenny Benson and Heather Mitz are out for the defense. Forwards Kelly Smith and Julia Arrington are out with knee injuries. And Pavlina Skazna in the midfield out with plantar fasciitis. As Karina LeBlanc has it. Melanie out of Dusseldorf, a member of the German Olympic team, as well as in the 99 World Cup. 10 points on the season.
She's finding a rhythm now. And I like what the Philly Charge is doing today. They are playing a very patient possessional game, which has always been their trademark, and it's very attractive.
Miner trying to get away from Cruz. Well, it doesn't hurt to add, too, once again, that as they try and go over the top to Pichon, who are the people running alongside Marinette? Well, you got LeBlanc, who is a world-class keeper, starts for the Canadian team. You've got Jenna Klugel and Kate Sobrero, who have spent time with the U.S. national team. And Monica Gonzalez, who is with the Mexican national side. So Hoffman and Pichon able to pull some of this off against some of the best competition in the world. Christine Lilly. And the whistle will go against Gonzalez. Talked about some of the other action this weekend, that New York-Carolina matchup tonight, unfortunately for Carolina, as well as the entire league. Looks like another serious knee injury, this time to Danielle Fotopoulos for Carolina. And also tonight, Washington at Atlanta. Those are the top two offenses in the league going head-to-head. Of course, Cindy Parlow for Atlanta, the player of the week after the hat trick. Mia Hamm with 20 points on the season. Second leading scorer in the league. And I know you've been excited about Sandra Minner, one of the newcomers from Germany for Washington. They'll also have Jennifer Meyer joining the lineup, another German international for Jim Gabara's club.
What's interesting about Minner is she's got this quality to serve balls over distance the way Jen Grubb does. So now they've got two center backs that can ping a ball 60 yards with accuracy.
Billy thought the ball was over the touchline.
A lot of refereeing out there right now, Beth. Tullock.
Terrific to get by Munere Begay.
And actually, she was there for the return from Emily Burke, but Emily decided to complicate it a bit.
Tullock bump.
Yeah, look at this stuff from Tullock. Yeah, with pressure, she head juggle. Look at this, at speed, bouncing balls. Nice combination, really great skill there.
Stacey Tullock, the second year midfielder who has been pulled back to play defense out of Arizona State and Phoenix. Three-time All-American, has a goal and three assists on the season. But as we're talking about many injuries, a lot of adjustments have had to be made by Mark Kerkorian in the lineup. They have played solidly here this afternoon.
There is obviously a lot of time left, but looking at the adjustments in the back, Mark Kerkorian and his players have made them very well. Tullock and Fair both doing superb jobs in the flank.
Well, Charles Schwab and Company Incorporated, member SIPC-NYSE, a proud sponsor of the WUSA. Visit one of over 350 investor centers nationwide and find out how Schwab can help you manage your investments. The yellow card comes out. Emily Burke is booked here in the 38th minute.
That's a compliment to Mary Frances Monroe. I was speaking with Jenna Klugel before the game, and she says that Mary Frances has been playing very well of late. And here she is under pressure, avoiding or trying to avoid Bert, who has to take her out. Good example of Mary Frances Monroe's skill under pressure.
Mary Frances making her third start of the year for the Breakers. Lori Fair clears it out of the box. Monroe running on, trying to get by Fair, bumped. And a free kick coming up for Boston just outside the area.
Hey, who's on 13? Set it!
That's Melissa Justin Moore in goal.
He's on 13. That means who is tracking Christine Lilly?
Let's go there.
Lilly standing over the ball right now along with Mara Miner. Miner will take it, looking to bend it over the top and miss just wide left.
Not a bad attempt.
McDonald's and Powerade love to see those winning smiles. There's Marinette Pichols after the first goal, and then Dogny Melgren after the equalizer. McDonald's and Powerade love to see those winning smiles. Pichols' goal, her ninth of the season, coming in the 29th minute, followed 4 minutes later by Dogny Melgren with her seventh of the season.
Nice skill there from Anne Makkinen under pressure.
Okay, get over there, guys.
Juggling it a bit, pushing it forward to Emily Burke. Watching this game, you wouldn't believe for a second it was a matchup between first and last.
Yeah.
Despite all their losses of personnel, the Charge is playing very well.
Push called on Makkinen in the area. Coming up on the Hyundai halftime report, we gave a camera to the players and let them document last week's All-Star festivities with some interesting results. Also, Lori Fair's on-field chatter will be in the Aflac player spotlight. That's coming up on the Hyundai halftime report. The WUSA on PAX. From Villanova Stadium, Philadelphia and Boston tied at one apiece. The Breakers coming in first place in the league. Philadelphia trying to get out of the basement. Just 9 points separating first and last place. Six teams are within 4 points of the top spot, just past the midway part of the season.
So what you're telling me, Beth, is everybody is still in it.
Yes, that would be the case. Four teams will move on to the playoffs.
And boy, watching the Philly Charge play today, you would have to say they're still in it. They've got Benson out, and they're still playing this well. They've got Mitz, obviously, out with that break. Kelly Smith, I mean, it seems like an endless line of quality players injured, and yet they're still turning in a quality performance here today against the Boston Breakers.
You got to do better now. Come on.
And, you know, maybe Mark Krikorian has come up with something, because Maren Meinert, clearly one of the elite players this season, is relatively quiet with Cruz all over her.
Melgren has made the most of her scoring opportunity. Hughes has had a few more looks, as has Christine Lilly. Perhaps because Philly has put a little more of the focus on Miner, but it's been successful in keeping her quiet to this point. The leading scorer in the league coming in is Maren Miner with 21 points on 8 goals. The All-Star MVP trying to settle it down at midfield. She's number 6 in white. They had a couple of goals last week in the All-Star game. Is widely considered to be the leading contender at this point for MVP honors. Here is Miner, looking to get an opportunity, trying to beat 3 red jerseys. Pops that one up.
They are tracking Miner all over the place, but here she sneaks away. You can see her subtlety. She was actually behind both defenders. They didn't know where she was. She made that short 3-yard burst, got free, tried to create something. She will be forever dangerous, even marked.
Deshaun playing it wide to Hoffman. Melanie turns it back inside, looking to get it back to Marinette. Mary Frances Monroe back to help out to clear it. Now Tulloch settles at midfield.
Well, looking at the numbers, we wanted them to track the direct play. Nelgren, three attempts. One of them's a goal. Pichon, eight, because she lives on that line. One goal. No offsides. So there's an aspect of the game that Pichon continues to obviously focus on. She lives on the line, and this game hasn't been called off once.
The two goal scorers in the first half. A minute of stoppage time will be added on. Mackinnon flicks it on. McCann boots it out of the box.
A part of that offside scenario for Pichon might also be that she has won so much respect from everyone in the league. The Boston Breakers, who obviously are incredibly familiar with it because Pia Sundhage coached here last year, maybe they're dropping a lot earlier to try to protect that space over the top.
Trying to beat it to the end line. Throw in for Boston here in the 45th minute. And here is Marinette Pichon, the most offsides in the league, but has stayed onside all day long.
And again, combination of factors. I genuinely feel that Boston is dropping off her because of their respect for her, but also the way they're playing today. The Philadelphia Charge is playing a tremendous possessional game. The goal that Pichon has was about a seven-pass series in the right flank as Pichon waited patiently for her chance to get in.
This is Hughes. Lily. Through her legs and over the touchline. A throw-in coming up as we are into stoppage time in the first half. Despite the losses, the Boston Breakers hanging tough with, or the Philadelphia Charge rather, hanging tough with first place Boston here at Villanova Stadium. Pinging around at midfield, settled by Gonzalez. Let's go over the top to Lily. Monroe. Trying to get by Masaki. Final moments of the first half. Marn Minor man marked by Rachel Cruz and has been kept quiet. And there's the final whistle on the first half of play. The league's leading scorer held in check, but Boston and Philly are tied at one. Coming up, the Hyundai Halftime Report.
Oh, look, it's the guy who falls.
Fall now.
Oh, I don't really do that anymore. It's not like I got that insurance.
What insurance?
Aflac.
They pay you cash if you can't work when you get hurt. Not that I ever do. Aisle 5 under lingerie.
Price check. Out.
So I was shooting my high school film project when my friend Nick came by. I'm like, hey, you got contacts.
Yeah, there's no fooling this kid.
Yeah, I've worn contacts before. They were annoying. They didn't fit right or...
These are different. They're Accu-View 2 contacts. They're perfect on me, and guess what? You're getting them too.
I'm like, all right, dude, that's good. My mom took us to the eye doctor. He figured out my prescription. Next thing you know, the Accu-View lenses were on.
It's great. I can actually see.
I don't even feel them in my eyes.
Contact lenses.
Make sure you ask for Accu-View 2 brand contact lenses.
What you got there?
It's a McGriddle sandwich from McDonald's.
What's in it?
It's good. It's like a bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich. Except it's got these two griddle cakes with the taste of maple syrup inside.
That's bizarre. Then again, it's not that bizarre.
New McGriddles. Bizarre, but yummy.
Ready for this? I call it the Super Slammer.
Dunk your grandma.
Skip to my loop.
Through the legs. Behind the back. Chocolate Thunder Attack.
Gorilla. Head turning. Body chilling. What you feeling? Horizontal, monumental, turbo power, magical rim rack. Yeah,
about pink that
makes you feel so good. Introducing Venus from Gillette in a scandalous new color, Passion Pink. Each refill has three blades and soft cushions that give you the closest shave. So close, your skin stays smoother, longer. Which makes it easy for every goddess to reveal her beauty. New Passion Pink Venus. Reveal the goddess in you.
Welcome to the Hyundai Halftime Report, brought to you by Hyundai. Hyundai, more features, more value, and America's best warranty. Halftime here in Philly. Last week during the All-Star festivities, we gave some of the stars a camera to take us behind the scenes.
All right, so how did...
Oh, that's nice. We are ready to kick some...
Harry, where are you? You got it?
Here we are today, teeing it up. What is the biggest handicap?
What do I hit? I hit trees.
Not
a good 85.
Wow, she's a good golfer.
I think we're going to the VIP party.
Yeah. Not only are there all-star players here, but all-star commentators as well.
Let's get them.
Sensation Burger Prince here. How do you feel about the answer card?
I don't know. I'm so excited about this. I can't say anything.
Aquí está Maribel Dominguez.
Yeah.
El bend it like Beckham. Bend it like Maribel.
That was funny. Let's leave it there. Let's cut it off.
Finish. There it is. Finish. So like it is.
Tied at one, Boston and Philadelphia. Today in our Aflac Player Spotlight, it's Lori Fair. Aflac, ask about it at work.
No, I just said take a couple touches, but... Slide over. Coming in. Hey, push up there, Keyshawn! Mel, go ahead! We gotta do it sooner, Melanie! Coming in, Mary, coming in! Start to go.
You don't need to head to the beach. You can head over to Villanova Stadium to watch the charge. The Aflac Halftime Report rolls on.
You go first.
No, you go.
There's a better way to get rid of blackheads.
Ouch.
New Clean and Clear Blackhead Clearing Scrub has multi-action beads that clean deep and keep blackheads away. Clean and clear and under control.
Starting today, muscle pain is no reason for. Not taking off, not touching down, not raging, not ice dancing, not going vertical, not hitting the wall, not hacking, not taking the gloves off, not getting dirty. Introducing new Tylenol 8 Hour with two layers, one that's fast and one that lasts. All day, one dose. New Tylenol 8 Hour. It's the Tylenol for muscle pain. Because not playing is not an option.
You're really good.
Yeah, almost as good as a man.
Where she comes from.
Girls aren't supposed to play soccer.
The rules.
No more soccer.
We're made.
You just can't take no for an answer.
To be broken.
1, 2, 3, 4.
I'm joining a girls team.
Huh?
It like Beckham.
Ray, you must be very proud.
Not at all. And you shouldn't encourage her.
Rated PG-13. Now playing only in theaters.
Honey, wipe your face.
Stains just aren't a big problem with the Maytag Neptune. Features like Stain Brain take the guesswork out of stain removal. And the Turbo Clean Wash System powers out tough stains. Right now, save up to $150 on Maytag washers. There's never been a better time to buy the longest lasting brand of washers available. Visit Maytag.com to find a dealer near you.
Maytag, depend on us.
Welcome aboard. Please turn off all unapproved electronic devices. We have a very crowded flight today, and all overhead space is full. The captain expects frequent turbulence, so please remain seated at all times. And we do anticipate a late arrival. Thank you.
The
Hyundai Santa Fe with America's best warranty. 10 years, 100,000 miles. When you upgrade your travel plans, you win.
Yo! Got a nasty cut? Get state-of-the-art protection. Band-Aid brand Advanced Healing. This amazing gel strip stays put for days. And it's clinically proven to help cuts heal faster. Advanced Healing. Only from Band-Aid brand.
Welcome back to the Hyundai Halftime Report. Boston and Philadelphia tied at one here at Villanova Stadium. And let's take a look, Anson, at the highlights from the first half of play.
Well, one of the things we want to look at is this defensive presence. Here's Rachel Cruz smothering Marin Miner. And here's Jennifer Teachin-Prazo on Dogney Meldrin. But I love this series. Being around comfortably on the right flank. They select their moment, knock it into this finisher, Marinette Pichon, who drives it home. But they are not done. Here's a chance for the equalizer. Perfect timing. Dogney Meldrin gets in, pushes it lower right, and the score is level.
And the statistics from the first half.
You look at these stats and you're thinking, gosh, Boston is absolutely all over Philly, but it doesn't feel like that from up here. The Philadelphia Charge are holding the ball very well. They're playing an excellent possessional game. It just doesn't feel like 7-2. Doesn't feel like that kind of Boston domination.
On the scoreboard, it's 1-1. And the fans over roaming around in the fun zone.
It's the bottom of the ninth, 4-3, two on, two out, with the entire season in the balance. No reason to hold anything back now. It all comes down to this.
Just hang in there.
Games don't come any bigger, and this one is going right down to the wire. The pitch.
Go.
He got a hold of it. Pitch.
Yes.
The Hyundai Sonata with America's best warranty. 10 years, 100,000 miles. When you don't miss a thing, you win.
This is no place for a bandage. Till now. From Band-Aid brand comes the Liquid Bandage. An instant waterproof seal that stays on anywhere, which helps every cut heal fast. Liquid Bandage from Band-Aid brand.
Really good.
Yeah, almost as good as a man.
Where she comes from.
Girls aren't supposed to play soccer.
The rules.
No more soccer.
We're made.
You just can't take no for an answer.
To be broken.
1, 2, 3, 4.
I'm joining a girls team.
Huh?
Bend it like Beckham.
Ray, you must be very proud.
Not at all. And you shouldn't encourage her.
Rated PG-13. Now playing only in theaters.
My name is Desmonda, and I have emphysema from smoking. To my children, forgive me for leaving you so soon. This is so hard for me. I don't want you to be sad. Remember me with strength and stamina. Not like this woman I have been transformed to. I love you.
You go first.
No, you go.
There's a better way to get rid of blackheads.
Ouch.
New Clean and Clear Blackhead Clearing Scrub has multi-action beads that clean deep and keep blackheads away. Clean and clear and under control.
This copyrighted telecast may not be retransmitted, reproduced, or rebroadcast without the express written consent of Women's Professional Soccer.
Welcome back to the Hyundai Halftime Report. Boston and Philadelphia tied at one. The WUSA on PAX. At each nationally televised game, two fans have three chances to kick through their choice of three boxes to win some money, $500, $750, or $1,000. First up, Laura Friedman, an 11-year-old from Flemington, New Jersey, is a big Charge fan and loves to watch Mia Hamm. She plays for the Flemington Red Devils. And then her dad, Jeff Friedman, who's a big Heather Mitch fan for the Charge. He's even got the jersey on. He takes a stab at it. The Hyundai Halftime Kickers. That's the Hyundai Halftime Kick. Hyundai, a proud charter sponsor of the WUSA. That'll take care of the Hyundai Halftime Report. When we come back, we'll go inside Boston's locker room with our head coach, Theo Sundar.
Honey, wipe your face.
Stay
stains just aren't a big problem with the Maytag Neptune. Features like Stain Brain take the guesswork out of stain removal. And the Turbo Clean Wash System powers out tough stains. Right now, save up to $150 on Maytag washers. There's never been a better time to buy the longest-lasting brand of washers available. Visit Maytag.com to find a dealer near you.
Maytag. Depend on us.
Welcome aboard. Please turn off all unapproved electronic devices. We have a very crowded flight today, and all overhead space is full. The captain expects frequent turbulence, so please remain seated at all times. And we do anticipate a late arrival. Thank you.
The Hyundai Santa Fe, with America's best warranty. 10 years, 100,000 miles. When you upgrade your travel plans, you win.
When my friend Rob came in, I realized that he wasn't wearing his glasses.
What's happening?
What are you doing here?
Got a little surprise.
He had the AcuView 2 contact lenses on, and he was telling me how great they are.
Feel like going to get a pair of those today?
Putting something on your eye freaked me out. If you beat me, I'll try contacts. I got spanked. My dad took us to the eye doctor. He figured out my prescription. Next thing you know, they run. I see everything clear. I see everything crisp and clean. It's like I'm not wearing anything.
Make sure you ask for AcuView 2 brand contact lenses.
What you got there?
It's a McGriddle sandwich from McDonald's.
What's in it?
It's good. It's like a bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich. Except it's got these two griddle cakes with the taste of maple syrup inside.
That's bizarre. Then again, it's not that bizarre.
New McGriddles. Bizarre, but yummy.
Boston and Philly tied at 1-1. One of the injured players for the Philadelphia Charge rookie Delia Arrington out with an ACL injury. Five different starters out of the lineup today for Philadelphia. On the other side, let's head inside the Boston locker room in Pia Sundog.
And switch the point of attack in the back. Don't play that long ball. Switch the point of attack and wait for the right moment. Jenna, bang, around again. We have 45 minutes. So from one side to another, and all of a sudden, you two, remember New York. Remember New York. And do it again. Find the rhythm. Okay? Defending, high pressure.
Interesting listening to Pia at halftime. She's talking about changing the point in the back. The reason they should be doing that is the Philadelphia Charger playing with one front runner, so that's the best area of the field to change the point through, four against one. And I think she's right on the money. That's the area they've got to change through. There's no pressure up there. It's just Pichon.
Certainly has some experience. You saw her numbers as a player for 21 years with the Swedish national team. And she was talking about remember New York. They were down a goal in that game and rallied to come back on Wednesday night to win it on an Angela Hughley's goal, her first of the season.
And Jenna Klugel was telling me that they just played superbly in that game, not just the fact that came back, but apparently it's one of their best games of the season.
Boston in all red, Philly in all red, Boston in the white shirts and the black shorts. Once again, one of the big stories for Philadelphia defensively, choosing to man mark Meinert today. Meinert, the leading scorer in the league, 8 goals, 21 points, and she is being checked closely by Rachel Cruz, the rookie, making her third consecutive start in Boston, making a change. Heather Aldama coming on for Monica Gonzalez. Moore trying to punch it out. Lily looking to keep it in. Hoffman settles it down. So a defensive substitution for the Breakers, bringing in Aldama for Gonzalez, who will be leaving the team on Monday to join the Mexican national side. Mexico plays Japan, looking for a spot, the final spot in the World Cup.
The thing I've enjoyed about watching Maren Miner over her career here is all the extraordinary things she can do with the ball. Look at that. Putting a hat on someone by juggling it over. These are three people that surrounded her. She still gets away, gets the shot off. Here, getting a sense of pressure from all sides. Again, pulls it back away from pressure. What an exquisite player.
Deshaun blasts that one up over the top. Marinette got things started with her ninth goal of the season in the 25th minute, assisted by Misaki and Hoffman. And then Dagny Melgren came back in the 29th minute, assisted by Hughes, to tie it up. But that particular combo, Hoffman and Pichon, getting better with every game they play together.
Well, I've never seen Hoffman play this well, and now I can see why Coach Mark Krikorian was so excited about injecting her into the lineup. I think she's adjusted now to the American style, which is a more energetic style than they classically play in Europe. And earlier, we didn't see much energy. Now we're seeing her play with energy, and now we're seeing the things she can do with the ball that are quite remarkable.
Well, the German players that we have seen bode pretty well for the German national side at the World Cup, especially if they can talk Maren Miner into coming back to the national team.
You know, I just can't believe that she doesn't have the interest in playing. I mean, her reason was very noble, that she didn't want to displace someone that had been there for 2 years. She can't just jump back in it. But, you know, whoever that number 18 or 20 player is in the bottom of the roster, they should be calling her up saying, you know, please take my place. Because, boy, does she change a game when she's out there.
Emily Burt tangled up a moment ago. She's back on her feet. Foul will be called on Christine Lilly for the shove on Mackinnon. Christine thought she was on the receiving end of that one. So it once again will be Lori Fair, looks like, standing over a free kick here for Philadelphia. LeBlanc instructing Maren Miner to get into the wall, and Tijan Frazzo kicks it right to Karina LeBlanc in goal.
It is nerve-wracking back there on goal, isn't it, Beth? The goalkeeper's running their lungs, both of them, for a free kick, making sure everyone's tracked or marked, and then invariably the ball either comes right at him or sails over the bar. What were you so worried about?
It's that old 70s song, All By Myself, Do Wanna Be All By Myself, back there.
And actually, I'm kidding. Obviously, the great goalkeepers have to be leaders, and they have to make sure that the tone of their voice is communicating the urgency of their command.
Are you kidding?
So good for Karina LeBlanc.
Out of Maple Ridge, British Columbia, also home to baseball star Larry Walker, as well as former Boston Bruin great Cam Neely. Into the area, knotted on by Tulick. And off the foot of Munare Begay, and our first corner kick of the game.
That was a well-engineered free kick. I think that was choreographed. There was nothing accidental about that.
Lori Fair will take the corner kick for Philly. Melgren got a header on it. Philadelphia still possessing. Hoffman. Her cross in front. Cleared out by the Boston defense. Foul will be called on Miner for the push. And once again, a free kick coming up for Philly. The charge starting to put the pressure on.
Two very dangerous set pieces in a row, and Pia Sundog is worried about this. She feels this is an area where her team still needs to improve.
Far post in the area, handball called on Philly as Pichon tried to knock it down. She's saying my elbow somehow just got in the way of that one.
Interesting, her arguing that from here it looked like it did hit her.
And from the replay, it is clear that it hit her. So, qu'est-ce que c'est, Marinette? It looked like to us it hit your hand.
The only argument you could possibly see there was it didn't hit my hand, it hit my wrist or my elbow or my shoulder, which really doesn't matter. At that point, it's all the same.
Oh, no, Beth, bad news. French embassy.
Oh, yeah. Questioning your negotiating skills.
Well, you know, we're having a little political trouble right now with France.
And we'll just leave it at that. Guichon again trying to get behind the ball. Ball still down. Marinette turns and fires. Misses wide.
I'll tell you, great series by Guichon here. Relentless. Just never giving up. Actually pulling it out of the hand of LeBlanc. Spinning, trying to hammer it home. Just missing. And still great intensity. And, you know, she, I love her energy. I love watching her play. What a pleasure to have her in this league.
Doing some cheerleading at the tail end of that play. Time to get the crowd fired up here at Villanova Stadium. Munire Begay now has it for Boston. She turns and strikes, puts it over the top of the crossbar. The American Legacy Foundation is the official cause of the WUSA. The WUSA supports the American Legacy Foundation in its efforts to build a world where young people reject tobacco and anyone can quit. 53rd minute, Philly and Boston tied at one. Guichon and Melgren, the goal scorers. Philadelphia playing without Heather Mitz and Jenny Benson. Mitz out with the leg injury. Benson sitting out a red card suspension. And then Rachel Hoffman, 16 in red, has to be careful as well. If she gets a yellow today, she would have to serve a suspension in their next game.
Just watching Maren Meinert in there, dying for them to serve her the ball over the top.
Well, you mentioned earlier, too, Anson, it takes a special kind of poise to deal with somebody pretty much being your shadow the entire day, as Meinert is dealing with Rachel Cruz, man marking her all over the field.
What I'm enjoying about watching Maren Meinert is she wants the ball, even though she's marked. She wants to prove that marking her is a waste of time. She's still demanding it.
Guerrero looking for service over the top. Lily ends up with Heather Aldama, brings it back inside. Monroe running on the edge of the area, deflected down by Tijan Frazzo.
Actually, look at the injection of Heather Aldama into the game. One of the best qualities she gives any team she plays for is what we just saw, her getting a player in with a perfectly paced pass. Technical qualities are superb.
Now we're seeing Boston do what Pia Sundhage talked about at halftime. Keep changing fields. Unfortunately for Boston, that one goes over the far touch a little bit too far out of the field.
Take your line.
Bird to Hoffman. Trying to give it back to Emily. Hughes was there tracking back.
Again, very patient build-up by the Boston Breakers, holding in the back, and again, doing exactly what Pia Sundhage suggested, which is to change it through the back, because there is limited pressure back there. Mark Krikorian's strategy is to put pressure 5 yards on the other side of the center circle.
Now they go over the top after trying to lull Philly to sleep. Tijan Frazzo with the defensive play. Cabrero, this time looking for Lily. Lori Fair gets ahead on it. Throwing coming up for Boston. Tied with Philadelphia here in the 57th minute.
This game is
Don't you love it? Rachel Cruz marks Maren Minor even when she's throwing the ball in. Now that's following coach's instructions.
Good way to keep yourself in that starting lineup as well for the rookie out of West Virginia.
Hawkins for Mary Frances Monroe, so what they get is a bit more bite in midfield with this change. Although Mary Frances on the ball has had an excellent game.
The Boston Breakers making their second substitution as Devin Hawkins, the rookie out of Santa Clara, comes on. The number three pick in this year's draft after winning a national championship in Santa Clara in her junior year. She teamed up with Danielle Slayton and Allie Wagner on that squad. There's a good look at Devin. Suffered a stress fracture in her left foot in early May. That has hampered her. She has one goal on the season. That was scored against Philadelphia in Boston's win earlier this year. She looks like a target right now, the way she's lining up on this corner kick. It doesn't go short.
Hakkinen tracking her closely.
Munire Begay takes the deflection and Masaki right in front of the goal.
Masaki says, I trap your shots on the goal line.
For she and her Portland Pilots beat Santa Clara this year to win the national championship.
She was a part of a superb midfield that did it.
Clive Charles won his first national championship. Let's revisit our Aflac trivia question. We've got the answer for you. How many Boston Breakers were on 1999 World Cup rosters around the world? And the answer would be 7. In fact, that is the most in the league, tied with the New York Power.
Aflac.
Our Aflac duck providing the trivia for us today.
That's us.
And a throw in for Philadelphia.
Great work there by Marinette Bichon to strip McCann and actually leave her there, wasted for a while. And McCann is a tough player. You can see the totality of Pichon's game, not just an attacking personality, but also willing to carry some of the workload.
Tijan Prazo throw into the area. Ricocheting around in the box. Still not out. And finally, Hawkins clears. Munire Begay. The Breakers on a breakout. Melbourne and Minor running up top. Maren Minor looking to turn it inside. Again, Rachel Cruz was right there with her.
Rachel Cruz being a thorn in Maren Minor's side. Always there, making it tough on her every time she receives possession, even in an environment like that where she had a chance to run at the line 1v1. If this works today for Mark Krikorian, we might see this again in the league.
Google. Into space, Munire Begay trying to run on, and a goal kick coming up. Today's game is brought to you by Band-Aid Brand. Buy Hyundai. Hyundai reminds you when you get everything you want, it's standard, you win. By Charles Schwab, proud sponsor of the WUSA. And by Powerade, refueling the WUSA.
Excellent header there by Cruz to keep it away from Maren Minor.
We are in the 61st minute. Boston and Philadelphia tied at one apiece. The WUSA on PAX. Coming up later tonight, Washington will be at Atlanta. Carolina will visit New York. And then tomorrow night on the West Coast, San Jose at San Diego. We saw Allie Wagner, the top pick in the draft this year, having her best game in a San Diego Spirit uniform. She had a couple of assists last week in the win against New York. Julie Fleeting had 5 points in the win against New York last week. And they will be taking on a San Jose team coming off their midweek 2-0 victory over Carolina. And that'll be out at Torero Stadium tomorrow night. Of course, everybody wants to get to Torero Stadium on August 24th for Founders Cup 3.
Come on!
To determine the WUSA championship.
That's a foul!
That was Mark Krikorian looking for the foul down on the Philadelphia bench.
That was tough for him to do, Beth, because he had to take off his headset first, then scream like a wild animal. Then I think he's put it back on now.
And in fact, Mark is joining us now down on the sideline. And Mark, the strategy thus far, how would you assess Rachel Cruz on Maren Minor to this point?
Well, I think Rachel's done pretty well. She's done a good job of taking dangerous situations away, and when she gains the ball, keeping it, as you see here for us. And I'd say so far it's been successful.
Mark, one thing I've really enjoyed is watching you guys possess it, despite the fact so many of your starters are out. The goal was an incredible series on the right side. Talk about your possession game today.
Yeah, Anson, we're very pleased with it. Obviously, there are other situations where we'd like to be able to keep it, for the most part, I'd say it's pretty good. We do have the weapon of Pichon in behind, and she had a couple of other chances as well, so we're looking to vary our attack as usual, and so far, I'd say we've been okay.
And I also think, from what I've seen, this is Hoff best game. Is this the way she's been playing, or do you think she's getting better now?
Well, she's getting better recently. I think she started to adjust to the game and getting a little bit more in tune with playing here out of the Bundesliga and stuff. So it's a little bit different, a little bit of an adjustment, but I think she's doing fine.
Thank you very much, Mark Krikorian, the head coach for Philadelphia. Of course, Rachel Hoffman coming over from the Bundesliga in Germany. Teaming up with Marinette Pichon. She seems to be having a lot of fun doing that. They were part of the goal for Philadelphia along with Aaron Misaki. Pichon scoring in the 25th minute. And there is Misaki knocking it away from Lilly, but a throw-in coming up for Boston.
And speaking of Hoffman's energy, that's Hoffman going all the way back to double, almost on her own end line. To confirm what Mark Krikorian was saying about her adjustment and playing better and better in this league.
It's gotten to the point, Anson, when you talk to players around the league, that this has become such a tremendous primer, and in fact, in most instances, is even better competition than some of the international games they'll play, where the competition isn't always as good day in and day out as it is in the WUSA.
Well, there's no question. I mean, one of the problems the United States has when it plays an international game is very few teams can actually put them under the kind of stress the day in, day out matches in this league do for the players from the United States. And you've seen the improvement in Hoffman since she's been in the league, confirmed by what Coach Mark Krikorian was saying. So not only are we serving our own players, but we're serving the world's game and their players as well.
Well, log on to WUSA.com for live scoring, player chats, TV schedules, trivia, and all the latest news about your favorite WUSA players. It's WUSA.com. Rachel Cruz was the chat this week on WUSA.com, getting the start today for Philadelphia and drawing the man-marking responsibilities on the league's leading scorer, Maren Minor.
Beth, is less compaction now. So it's going to make it harder for the teams to defend effectively.
Mackinnon looking for Pichon LeBlanc. How to make the play.
No better example than that. The too much space in midfield now. The teams aren't staying compact. They're concentrating less when the ball goes from side to side. And you're going to see more opportunities like that. But what's also happening is the energy level's dropping a bit, which is one reason there isn't compaction and concentration.
This is really when you start to see the training come into play. The fittest one still going full bore. Looking for Pichon up top, and now Boston headed the other way. Minor trying to get in behind Cruz. Press pressure defensively in the midfield. Kugel looking for Stephanie Mounere-Begay. Keeps it in play, and Moore calling for it. Scoops it up.
Looking at this last series, you can see the incredible ton of the goal of space in midfield. Now look at this. At this moment, perfectly level. And now watch. Ball gets through. And talk about timing. That's why she's so extraordinary on the line. Her timing is exquisite. And looking at the stats that we're gathering, the direct balls, the attempts over the top, you can see into Pichon's 11. No offsides today with a goal. Several more chances, as Coach Kerkorian pointed out. Six for Melgren, so you can see this is still a great weapon for both teams. Both goals resulted off the direct ball in behind.
Both those players will be representing their countries at the World Cup in September and October here in the United States. Of course, Pichon with the French team and Dagny Melgren with the Norwegians. A lot of speculation as to whether Maren Meinert will make a return to the German side. We talk about competition for the United States. Of course, the U.S. beating China in the 99 Cup. It's been Norway in a lot of the major competitions, including the 2000 Olympics, that have given the United States the most trouble. Norway won the gold in Sydney.
They're tough. Their mentality is so tough to match up with. The Norwegians are one of the few countries that match our mentality.
Minute at Villanova Stadium in Villanova, Pennsylvania. The Philadelphia Charge and the Boston Breakers tied at one apiece. Boston in their road whites, Philly in their home red jerseys. Next Saturday afternoon at 4 Eastern, 1 Pacific, San Jose at New York. And here's an opportunity for Meinert, and it goes right to Melissa Moore. Hoping she would have been able to do a little more with that chance.
Absolutely incredible opportunity. Right now she's kicking herself. That was a chance she would finish. Gosh, two out of three times. Maybe even more. I'm sure she's incredibly disappointed. The fact she got away is to her credit.
Pichon again with Sobrero giving chase. And a corner kick coming up for Philadelphia.
And then having a drink there. It's very hot out there.
Lori Fair looking for Pichon in the air. Puts it over the top.
Here's a chance Maren Meinert should have finished. Great ball in over the top. She even looks to see where the goalkeeper is. Just touching it over. She's got the skill to do this. Unbelievably bad finish for her to knock it straight into Melissa Moore's hands. That should have been over her head and in the net. Boston should be up 2-1.
Seeing some of the things that their GM Joe Cummings has called her on occasion the Larry Bird of women's soccer when he refers to Maren Meinert. I think that's a great analogy.
Yeah, and you know what was hilarious when Maren Meinert heard about this, she said, well, I think that's a compliment.
We'll have to get her some old Boston Celtics tape for her to watch. I think she would definitely consider that complimentary. Here is Meinert trying to get around Cruz. Look at the skill with the ball. Now Lori Fair has it for Philly. Fair, one of the players that has moved out of her natural position due to all the injuries. Usually playing in the midfield, has moved back as the right defender.
Inadvertently brilliant dribbling by Emily Burke.
Is it possible to be inadvertently? I guess it is possible to be inadvertently brilliant.
Well, you were watching it, weren't you? You know, from her toe to the other kid's kneecap to her shin to, you know, space in front of her. I mean, you think that was choreographed?
I'm sure most occasions that any of us are brilliant, it's inadvertent. 72nd minute, tied at one. Boston looking to shore up its hold on first place. A win today would keep them on top for another week. Right now they are a point in front of Atlanta. Three up on Washington, and then San Diego, San Jose, and New York all tied for fourth place. 4 points out of the lead. Got a 6 weeks left in the regular season of the WUSA before the playoffs start.
Beth, I hate to do this, but I think the referees have had another very good game.
Another example of inadvertent brilliance?
Well, I don't know. One of my favorites was two players collided and fell over, and usually the referee tries to basically blame one of the two, and she didn't. She kept her whistle quiet.
Perhaps that's why Kerry Seitz was named the referee of the year last season in the WUSA.
Well, the thing I like about her, she knows this is a game for the players, and she makes sure that she's not a part of it unless she has to be.
Hughes puts one over the top. She's had a few opportunities from just outside the edge of the area today. The WUSA is proud to support the American Legacy Foundation as part of Legacy's Circle of Friends program. The WUSA stands with women who are trying to quit smoking and will make a donation to Legacy for every goal scored during the season. Marinette Michon, Darvin and Eldrin, the goal scorers this afternoon. Heather Aldama, a second-half substitution, controlling for Boston. Trying to get by Lori Fair, who makes the sliding tackle. Fair, not only a tremendous soccer player, but also an author.
Yes.
Fair Game, her new book out this summer. Have to look for that in bookstores in your area. I hear, understand it is both informative and instructional, as well as entertaining.
Her personality really comes through in the book, and I think it'll be a wonderful book for kids to get an insight into her, but also into developing their own games.
A lot of the players, including Lori, take on the added responsibility of Anson of selling the league, selling their teams, promoting their teams within their cities. And she has spent a lot of time on local television, local radio, trying to drum up support for the charge. Cross, Moore gets a mitt on it.
That looked like she rebounded it. Didn't she go up with one hand? I mean,
tried to cup that one.
Beth, wasn't that your game collegiately? Didn't that look like a rebound to you?
I was nowhere near being inadvertently brilliant at it, by the way.
Just a second ago, I saw Cruz level. Paul, looking at this opportunity here, the ball's whacked in. Let's see. Excellent one-handed rebound. Or did she have two hands up there? It's hard to tell.
She got. She would have been able to touch the net. I think the basketball net on that reach.
I was trying to share a moment earlier that Cruz leveled Maren Meinert by accident and then apologized. So obviously, Rachel Cruz has huge respect for the young woman she's been asked to mark.
There they are. They've spent a lot of time together today. Miner's best chance coming a few moments ago when she was able to get in behind the defense, but not able to finish. Stacy Tulloch. Bert has it. This is Stephanie Mounere-Begay.
The thing I've liked about Mounere-Begay today is her ability to run and penetrate with speed coming through midfield. It's a quality that sets her apart.
Miner trying to get by Cruz, a throw-in coming up for Boston.
That was a bit comical. I think Fair and Cruz thought she was going to clear it out and ducked, and then the slow roller came out between them.
Lily will put it back into play again. Get a running start at this one.
Speaking to
kiss of death, but Mark Kerkorian's makeshift defense has done very well.
Boston with another throw-in. Tisha Carrazzo, really the only player that has started back there in every match for Philly. The other three in that back four you talked about, Ethan, are all playing out of position or have been in and out of the lineup.
Another substitution here.
Aaron Misaki will come off. Karen Hall will head on for Philadelphia.
Actually, I expect to see more substitutions. The game on this surface, unbelievably hot. I'm sure the players are becoming exhausted dealing with the heat and the amount of energy this game is required.
It's been a sun-drenched afternoon here at Villanova Stadium. The humidity not all that high, but once again, the sun has been beating down on that synthetic turf all day.
I'm sure it's 10 to 15 degrees hotter just from playing on that surface.
Temperature in the mid-80s here in Philadelphia. Then Boston looking to switch fields. They do so.
It's interesting with the substitution taking Mary Frances Monroe out. They're not attacking as well through central midfield. They probably have a better defensive presence. But so much of what's happening in the middle of midfield, the ball's going back when it could be going forward.
That was Devin Hawkins who came on for Mary Frances Monroe. Now Karen Hall, the recent substitute for Philadelphia, plays it back to Tulloch. Oh, almost skidded through right to Hoffman.
That was the old I got it, you got it thing, and both of them ducked it.
Hawkins looking to play it out wide to Jenna Klugel. Philly with the throw-in, but Carrie Seitz looking over, and they will let the substitution come on. Jenna Klugel will head off. Ronkiel Gulbrandsen, known as Rags, the Norwegian international, will head on.
And let's see if the shape changes. They've taken Klugel out, and they've put in an attacking personality. She's running over to Marin. She's pointing Marin back. And I think this is a good move because it's very tough to mark someone, or a lot tougher to mark someone in midfield. So by, I guess, giving Marin some freedom to go back in midfield, let's see how this changes. And also with just Pichon up front, they don't really need four defenders in the back. So let's see if this tactical choice by Pia Sundhag pays off for them.
Meinert so far has stayed up top. Let's see if she does drift back from time to time. This is Gulbrandsen. Very good in the air, according to Pia Sundhag. That's what they like to try and utilize, and she's able to draw the foul.
And this is perfect for Boston because obviously they have the option to bend this free kick in from there. But with Gulbrandsen in there, they have an extraordinary target that, of course, they wouldn't have if she's not in there. And the thing she's known for, her, frankly, is her ability in the air. So let's see if they flight this up to her for her to head in or where they try the shot.
She's hanging out on the far post right now alongside Hawkins. Trying to run a little traffic for Lily and Meinert around the ball. Meinert will take it.
Yep,
looking for Gulbrandsen.
Yep, I think they were. I think watching Marin's look, she was trying to catch her across between the penalty spot and the 6-yard line.
Hawkins with the throw. Mackinnon blasted across midfield. Goes all the way back to LeBlanc. Rags trying to run on, but headed out of there by Mary McVay, the rookie out of Dartmouth. Started the first seven games. Then the lineup shakeup by Mark Krikorian, but due to the injury, she's back in there. Moonray Begay gets it back from Miner, trying to beat Susan Frazzo to the line. Corner kick for Boston.
Game shifted. It's almost like the field is tilted now. It's all tilted back in this direction. As the Philadelphia Chargers fending off Boston here in the closing 10 minutes.
Quick restart. And Lori Fair with a nice defensive play to take it away from Lily. Lou Branson winning one in the air. Still not out of trouble yet. Miner trying to run on. And there is Rachel Cruz once again.
I hope Rachel Cruz's mom and dad are recording this game for her, because she has played exceptionally well against, in my opinion, the league MVP.
We'd have to call her cruise control if she can continue to keep Miner in check. Sorry, I had to sneak that in.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
Ooh, I'm going to be fined for that one by our kangaroo court. Hoffman trying to keep it in play, does so.
Look at this. Great deception from Hoffman. Again, great energy tracking all the way back from our high midfield spot into the defensive third to help her Philadelphia Charge team out.
84th minute, Boston and Philly tied at one. Fichon scoring in the 25th minute. Melgren in the 29th for Boston.
Because of the change, the game is becoming a bit more direct with the new shape for the Boston Breakers. They're in a 3-4-3 now.
Fichon has a chance in the area. Meredith Fichon with her second goal of the day.
If there is a player that finds space on the edge of the restraining line any better than Meredith Fichon, I can't imagine. She found the seam between the right back and the center back. She found the line. She gets in and just hammers it with her left foot, lower left. In a gamble to try to win this thing by pulling Jenna Flugel off and playing with three in the back. She gave Marinette Pichon more space than you can afford to. And now they've pulled the ball out of the back of the net.
51 points now in 29 games, the fastest to that career mark of 50 in her WUSA career. Assisted by Lori Fair and Melanie Hoffman. And now looking for more, Pichon.
Isn't that great? She's not done yet. She's still sprinting, closing moments of the game. And Pichon still has the enthusiasm to play the game at a full sprint. She is an absolute clinic in mobility up top. She's a clinic on playing on the restraining line. She's a clinic on finishing chances in the attacking box. Actually, I'm looking forward to watching the French national team play now, from seeing how well she plays the Philadelphia Charge.
Marinette Pichon, two goals in the game. 2-1 Philadelphia with the lead over first place Boston. This would open the door for the winner of tonight's matchup between Washington and Atlanta to take over first place, or at least tie for the lead. Lily battling Mackinnon. 87th minute now. Elgin, she's got the goal today for the Breakers. Her cross. Lori Fair is there.
Great direct ball just then by Christine Lilly to find her Norwegian partner. Dogny Meldrin over the top. Another look at this exquisite finish by Marinette Pichon. Great ball. Perfectly paced. So perfectly paced that all Pichon had to do was to first time it into the back of the net.
That was Lori Fair that made the pass, serving it to Pichon. Fair hustling to keep it in play. Mäkinen takes it away from Hughley.
Excellent defensive presence there from Anne Mäkinen. She's showing a defensive presence that I haven't seen from her yet. I can hear the voice of Mark Krikoy on the sideline whipping his players to make sure their intensity doesn't drop and their shape doesn't suffer.
What a tremendous effort thus far from Philadelphia. Without two of their starters on the defensive line, Benson sitting out the red card suspension. Kukli. It up, Kukli's to Rags, 2-2 in the 88th minute.
And this is why the substitution was made. Gilbronson was in to try to create an opportunity, and look at what she finishes. Ball played back to her beautifully, first time's in the back of the net. Another look here, Lori Fair was climbing Gilbronson to make sure she couldn't finish it. Excellent pass back by Hughley's finish just under the bar.
Her first goal of the season. Is Gilbronson able to tie it up? And now Meldrin, she's offside. Dogny, too much on it.
It's really interesting to see something like this happen, Beth, where the coach makes a gamble and is burned on one side of the gamble but benefits on the other. Burned because she only had three in the back, given Pichon too much space, but then the girl she subs in is the one that finishes the chance. And let's see how the rest of this plays out.
Well, the coaching moves have been solid on both sides. First, Krikorian choosing the man mark Miner. Pia was a substitution to bring in Rags, pays off. The ball was over the near touchline when Miner tried to play it back into Lilly. 90th minute, tied at 2. Boston with the late goal. Trying to salvage at least a point for the tie. 2 minutes of stoppage time will be added on. Cruz able to keep it away from Miner. Hoffman. Will Marinette Pichon have an opportunity to get the hat trick? She's got 2 goals today.
I love watching Hoffman with the outside of her feet distribute so beautifully.
Hoffman back to Hall, looking for Pichon. Just missed it wide right. Oh, another good opportunity.
She's shaking her head because she knew that if she had known where the goal was, it would have been in the back of the net. I don't think she knew where it was. Great combination here. Great pass to get her in. She doesn't know. She didn't know where the goal was. She thought it was there and shot it wide. She shot it where she wanted to. Missed the goal.
Chance for the hat trick and possibly the game winner. Just a couple of feet off frame from Pichon.
To Philadelphia's credit, so many players out. Adjusted lineups. And yet, with a great chance there to put the game away.
Gilbronson, good ball to get it back to Lilly. Christine Lilly. Shot fire, saved by Moore.
The quality of the game hasn't dropped at all, despite the fatigue.
did get ahead on it. Otherwise, Keyshawn was behind her again. Into this second minute of stoppage time. Burt to Hall.
Great rhythm here.
Here comes Philly again. Burt turns and fires, deflected. And a corner kick coming up for Philadelphia. They'll have one more crack at it. Trying to win it here on perhaps the last play of the game. A 22! Lori Fair looking far post. And out of play.
I know Lori's disappointed in that one, especially you can see her shaking her head there, especially after that brilliant assist. And to Marinette Pichon, for her to miss that, I know she's disappointed, but still, what a great game.
McDonald's and Powerade love to see those winning smiles. Pichon in the 84th minute to put Philadelphia in front. And a little boogie as well. And then Gull Brunson in the 88th to tie it up with the quick counter. McDonald's and Powerade love to see those winning smiles. The final here at Villanova Stadium, Boston 2 and Philadelphia 2. Both of the Chargers' goals coming from Marinette Pichon. We'll be back in a moment.
Starting today, muscle pain is no reason for not taking off, not touching down, not raging, not ice dancing, not going vertical, not hitting the wall, not hacking, not taking the gloves off, not getting dirty. Introducing new Tylenol 8-Hour with two layers, one that's fast and one that lasts. All day, one dose. New Tylenol 8-Hour. It's the Tylenol for muscle pain, because not playing is not an option.
My name is Desmonda, and I have emphysema from smoking. To my children, forgive me for leaving you so soon. This is so hard for me. I don't want you to be sad. Remember me with strength and stamina. Not like this woman I have been transformed to. I love you.
Aflac.
It gives your mommy money if she's sick and can't work.
What does?
Aflac.
Pay attention.
To what?
Aflac.
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Aflac.
The final here in Philly. The Charge and the Boston Breakers tied at two apiece. Today's play of the game is brought to you by Maytag, and it's Marinette Pichon on the goal, but she had plenty of help, Anson.
What I liked about